I've done several videos for soundproofing showing how some soundproofing work that I did on a walls in one room a number of years ago, how it actually performed when there was severe noise happening outside my apartment. And I wanted to talk today about some of the lessons I've learned on the work that I did maybe 15 years ago, what I would have done differently now if I knew as much 15 years ago as I know now about soundproofing and soundproofing processes. Let's take a look at some of the things I did with Quiet Rock and green glue and what I would have done differently now. And I wish I could go back in time and tell my previous self that my future self was going to need more video and photos of the process back then. But let's go over it now. So, like everyone, I learned about noise by trial and error. We're not born knowing all about acoustics, and you don't really think about a noise until it starts to bother you. But once you start to understand noise, you learn how to identify the source. So the soundproof room that I've shown to you in other videos was done in increments. I should say sound-reduced room because it's not 100% soundproof. The first phase was blowing cellulose insulation into the rear wall. I was preparing myself for a construction project that was going to happen directly behind me, and it was going to impact everyone in my building for almost 2 years. This is the first thing I learned. Noise is not unidirectional. Just insulating the one wall that faced the construction project was not going to stop the noise from coming into our apartment. The low-frequency sound from the construction went through the entire building frame and through all the walls, the floors, and the ceilings. However, when the construction wasn't happening, I realized how nice that wall was under normal, quieter circumstances. I knew that I wanted to eventually insulate everything. Our apartment was getting a lot of noise from the neighbors downstairs. Just everyday talking, nose blowing, sounds that you wouldn't expect to hear so clearly. Eventually, they did replace their ceiling, but that took years of negotiation. In the meantime, I was starting to learn about noise, and I decided to start insulating and soundproofing the walls of the upstairs apartment because I knew that even if we replaced the ceiling downstairs, I didn't want noise coming upstairs through their walls into my walls upstairs. I had already learned my lesson from insulating only one wall during the construction project. There's a term for this called flanking noise, when you treat one surface, but the noise sneaks in through another one. So I was reading about Quiet Rock drywall, and I found a local store that sold it. I wanted to test it on two of the walls in that room by removing the existing drywall and replacing it with Quiet Rock. The hardware store said, "This is all you need. Just put this on your walls and it will block the noise. You don't even need insulation." Well, I figured I would add insulation anyway, so we bought the most convenient insulation at that time, which was fiberglass bats. If I could do it again, I would have used Rockwool bats, of course. It's denser and more sound absorbent. But also, and this is important, I would not have attached the Quiet Rock directly to the wall studs. How did I first notice this issue? I started hearing a droning noise through that wall. It turns out that the building next door touches the exterior wall of my building in that area, and what I was hearing was the fan from the oven in the kitchen of the building next door. So here's what I learned from that experience. I learned that the new drywall should have been decoupled from the wall studs. Now there's a couple of ways to do this, and you've probably seen this already on other people's YouTube videos. You can install furring channels on the wall studs. You add the channel perpendicular to the studs and then attach the drywall to, say, a 25-gauge furring channel. This prevents the transfer of vibration or impact noise from the outside, and it goes through the wall studs and into your drywall. You don't want that. Or another quick trick that might have worked, apply Joist tape on the wall studs before adding the new drywall. This would have added some dampening to the back of the drywall and kept it from directly touching the wood frame. One technique that I read about is to try creating a fake staggered wall by applying the Joist tape to every other wall stud. This creates a small gap that's between the drywall and every other stud, and obviously you would not put any screws through the drywall where the gaps are, and put as few screws as possible to the studs with the Joist tape. I've never tried this, I wish I had, but it's an inexpensive hack that might have been more effective than simply attaching the drywall directly to the wood stud. That said, the Quiet Rock was pretty effective in blocking airborne noise, just not vibration and low frequency noise. The type that I bought was 5/8 inches, and it combines a type of concrete with gypsum, so it's pretty dense, but even concrete can transfer impact noise. So, after I had the experience of hearing the fan through the drywall, I decided to try something different on the other two walls. I decided to layer a sheet of Quiet Rock over the original drywall and put green glue in between the two layers. So I wasn't going to tear out the wall that already had cellulose insulation in it, and obviously I wasn't going to decouple it from the frame. But I thought maybe the two layers of dampening would help, plus I was adding an extra half inch of mass. So we bought some half-inch Quiet Rock drywall, which is basically two pieces of gypsum with a layer of dampening sandwiched in the middle. And we got some tubes of green glue and acoustical caulk and added the new drywall on top of the existing wall. One of those walls has a large window, so obviously some noise can come through there. You can see that this extra layer of drywall added more mass, and you can see it around the window. Because of the extra layers of dampening, these double walls are more effective against noise than single drywall, but they still aren't totally soundproof, because the original drywall underneath is still attached to the studs. Now all four walls have some kind of noise reduction and insulation in them. This has reduced certain types of noise a lot. Of course, some types of noise can still come through. In summary, noise is omnidirectional. Treating only one surface doesn't eliminate all noise. Insulation is not an effective solution on its own, especially for low frequency or impact noise, but it's great to combine it with other solutions. Replacing walls or floors without decoupling them will not eliminate impact or low frequency noise if this is a problem for you. Adding more layers with dampening between them might help to reduce noise more than a single layer, but it's less effective against impact noise. And also, never assume that the contractor you hire knows acoustics really well. You need to work with them to make sure you don't introduce new noise issues. Thanks for watching. For more information on noise and acoustics, visit soundproofus.com.